So one of the four research thrust areas within the Department of Industrial and Manufacturing Systems Engineering is human factors and ergonomics. The human factors and ergonomics group really focuses on two main areas, cognitive engineering and physical ergonomics. Cognitive engineering focuses in on things like the perception of the human and information processing of the human being. They also focus in on how do we use the information that we have about these different areas of cognitive engineering in the design of technology that people use. For example, designing the cockpit of an aircraft, or designing the interface between a human being and a computer system or some type of technology, understanding how people make decisions, what kind of errors they're likely to make, and those kinds of things are quite important when designing systems that people are going to use. The other area of focus within the broad area of human factors ergonomics is the physical ergonomics. And in physical ergonomics, we're again trying to understand the capabilities and limitations of the human operator, but we're doing that from a physical perspective. That is, we're very interested in understanding the strength capabilities and how the body gets injured in the workplace. Examples of projects that we have going on right now involve evaluating people who are performing repetitive lifting tasks, or looking to see how seated operators are fatigued. We have operators of farming equipment, for example, that spend 8, 10, 12 hours sometimes in that seat. How does that impact their fatigue and their performance? And then finally, we're also working on a project in looking at ergonomics in the surgical theater. How do surgeons and nurses and so forth work in that environment? And again, they're working for extended periods of time. 6, 8, 10 hours sometimes in a single surgery. And so understanding how these surgeons and nurses become fatigued and what we can do to help prevent that is an important part of ergonomics in that area. In terms of job opportunities, there are a number of different ways that people with these skills are found in industry. We see people with these particular skills in occupational and safety and health careers, where the company hires the person to come in and really evaluate the safety and the ergonomics of the jobs that their people are performing, because many of these injuries are extremely expensive, and if we can prevent just a few of these injuries, it makes a big impact on the bottom line for that company.